So we have seen some relatively general fault tolerance techniques. Now let's look at the fault tolerance techniques for memory and storage. We could use dual module redundancy or triple modular redundancy for memory and storage, but they are considered to be overkill for these devices. We can get better techniques that protect us from similar problems. So dual module redundancy and triple modular redundancy are typically used for the hardware that does the computation, which cannot be protected by some of the less expensive techniques that memory and storage can benefit from. And these techniques for memory and storage are called error detection or error correction codes. So the idea is that we can store bits with some extra information that allows us to detect and or correct one or more bits of error depending on the code. So we don't have to store everything twice or everything three times in order to achieve detection or correction of a single error. So the simplest technique that is often used for memory and storage is parity. With parity, we add one extra bit to the data bits, and that extra bit can be computed simply as an XOR of all the data bits. When we do have parity, if a fault flips any one of the bits, including the parity bit will no longer match the data. By flipping one of the bits, we are changing the result of this XOR to be the opposite of what it previously was. So when we read the data and the parity and we see that now the parity does not match data, we assume that there has been a bit flip, and that's how we detect a single bit error. The next level of error detection and correction codes is the so-called ECC, which stands for error correction code. And a typical example of this would be a type of code called SEC dead codes, or single error correction and double error detection code. So this code can detect any one bit flip and actually fix it. Or if there are two bit flips, we will find out that that happened, but we can no longer fix it using this code. An example of where this type of a code is used is in DRAM modules that have ECC. This is how they are protected. So pretty much if there is a single bit flip in such a module, you don't even notice, everything functions well. If there are two errors in the data that is protected by the same code, then we will get notified that there's been an error, but we cannot actually continue operating normally because actually we cannot correct the erroneous state anymore. Hard drives use even fancier codes, such as the Reed-Solomon codes that I'm not gonna go into here. And these codes can detect and correct multiple bit errors, and they're especially powerful when we have a streak of flipped bits, which happens, for example, when the head oscillates a little bit and while the disk is spinning, it for a while just is too high above the platter and misses some of the bits. And then for hard drives, in addition to these error detection and correction codes, there is a family of techniques called RAID that we will look at next.